In light of recent events, more people than ever are meeting virtually using Zoom. And whether you're a teacher giving an online class, a business person presenting to a customer, or a preacher giving a sermon, having a script to read from can help you present more confidently. So today, I'm going to show you how to read from a script while presenting on Zoom using an iPad. Using the Prompt Plus app, it is super easy. I'm currently presenting on Zoom and have overlaid my script next to the camera. Because the script is next to the camera, it looks like I'm making direct eye contact with the audience. I can tap the script to start and stop scrolling and easily control the speed using this slider. It's really easy to get set up too. First, go to the App Store and download Prompt Plus. I've given you a link in the description. Once it's installed, open it and log in. To load a script, tap the scripts icon and then tap the plus button to create one. There are various options for importing scripts from Dropbox, Google Drive, and other places, but I'm just going to create one from scratch. So I give my script a title, paste my text into the main script area, and tap save. Next, you need to place the Prompt Plus app icon in the dock. I'll explain why this is needed in just a second. For now, return to the home screen. The area at the bottom is called the dock. Drag the Prompt Plus icon into the dock and then tap done. Next, open up the Zoom app and start or join a call. This is the clever bit. Slowly drag upwards from the bottom edge of the screen to show the dock. Then tap and hold on the Prompt Plus icon and drag it onto the screen. As you drag it, you'll see the outline of the app window. Drag it over to the side of the screen nearest the camera and then release. Prompt Plus will remain overlaid on top of Zoom next to the camera. No one else will see your script, only you. They'll just see your lovely face making eye contact and presenting with confidence. When you're ready to present, simply tap the screen to start the script scrolling and tap again to pause. You can adjust the speed of scrolling by using the plus and minus buttons. Try to read from the middle of the screen, as this will keep your eyes as close to the camera lens as possible. If you prefer, you can also use a remote control to start and pause the recording. I've added a link to this one in the notes, but most will work with the app. Just make sure you get a Bluetooth one that's compatible with iOS devices. You can also use an Xbox or PlayStation controller, wireless keyboard, or even another iOS device. I'll be showing you how to do this in another video. To keep your hands free for your all-important gesturing, instead of using a remote, you can connect a foot pedal. This one by AirTurn has four controls that I use to start and stop scrolling, change direction, and increase or decrease the speed. Foot pedals made by AirTurn are officially supported by the developer, so I provided a link below. You can also display the apps next to each other in a split view layout by swiping downwards from the top edge of the Prompt Plus window and then dragging it across to the edge of the screen nearest the camera. Now, Prompt Plus is sharing the screen with Zoom, and you can adjust the app divider by giving more or less space to each app. To close the split view, simply drag the app divider over the app you want to close. And that's it. It really can be that simple to improve your presentation on Zoom. Prompt Plus is free to download and to use for short scripts. If you need to present using longer scripts, you can make a one-time purchase of the full app by tapping the upgrade button in the app's settings. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this guide helpful. Please make sure to watch my next video on how to use Prompt Plus with a professional teleprompter rig. Until then, goodbye.